The cortisol level is highest in the morning along with testosterone, aldosterone like that. And so, maximum of our physiological function circle round and round and round according to our clock. Like if we start from evening, like 21, the written here is 21, that means 7 o'clock. The melatonin starts synthesis around 7 o'clock, 7:30, and then finally, it starts 7:30 in the morning. There is written melatonin secretion stops in the morning. So this is our normal cycle when melatonin starts and then it is followed by the sleep. And midway, here there is number of functions like in midnight, there is midnight or around 8 to 9, the acid secretion is maximum. And later on morning, there is increased level of cholesterol. High alert, we are high alert around 10 a.m. and there is best coordination in our body around 2:30 p.m. with greatest cardiovascular efficiency and muscular strength around 5 p.m. So this is our normal biological clock. Now next, let us have a slide on chronopathology. Now here we can say there are number of diseases which rotate around this biological clock. If we talk about peptic ulcer, in peptic ulcer it is aggravated in the night because the acid secretion is maximum in the night. Here we can see asthma written here is it is around 4 o'clock in the morning, because in morning the allergy and the asthma, it gets aggravated. We will see the next slide, there are number of reasons why the asthma get aggravated. Then in 6 o'clock, between 8 to 9 o'clock, there is raised, highest rise in blood pressure is there in our body. And so likewise, we will see the clinical application. At that time also, we will follow this biological clock. So our diseases, they move round and round around the clock. And if you see, this is another slide which shows how this disease rhythm, they move around the time. Again, this chronopharmacology, it is having number of branches, chronopharmacokinetics, dynamics. Let us just have a look on the important part. So, first we start with chronokinetics. Now, absorption, distribution, metabolism and elimination, along with all the parameters given above, like plasma protein binding, enzyme, GFR, all these are again influenced by the circadian system. And if we talk about pharmacodynamics, the rhythm in receptor, numbers, conformation, second messenger, these are also influenced by the circadian rhythm. And therefore, here we can see according to the kinetics, number of a list is there of the drugs which are influenced by the circadian rhythm. Like here, there is given aminoglycoside. Now, aminoglycoside, it is having renal toxicity least during the daytime. So, we prefer when the renal toxicity is less, that means we can prefer maximum of the dose during the daytime to avoid the side effects. Likewise, we are running in shortage, we are having number of these like last in the end there we can see anti-cancer drug. Now anti-cancer drug, it is having the highest efficacy in the midnight because it is having very less toxicity in the midnight. So we prefer anti-cancer drug, high dose of anti-cancer drug in the night, because at that particular time the efficacy is more and the bone marrow toxicity is less. Again, I am having a long list of the drugs which move around the kinetics and dynamics. I can't elaborate on this. And morning dose, there are certain drugs which are preferred in the morning, like methyl prednisolone, thiazide, proton pump inhibitors, the allergic drugs, evening dose, theophylline for asthma, statins for hyperlipidemia, ranitidine, famotidine, which are given for peptic ulcer, these are again preferred evening, in the evening time. So here we come for the to the clinical implementation of the chronopharmacology. So chronotherapy, just we have a look, chronotherapy refers to the use of circadian or other rhythmic cycle in the application of the therapy. Now so talking about the applied chronopharmacology, so here we can see there is a long list that of the disease which are influenced by the circadian rhythm. If we talk about history, the first drug which was given regarding chronopharmacology was the cortisone, because we already know, we have already seen that during morning time we have the raised cortisone. So why not, if we are having adrenal suppression or any type of condition when we are having less cortisone, so why not to have a heavy high dose in the morning so that the deficiency would be replaced. So in the morning, this is the first drug which was started regarding chronopharmacology. And later on, if we talk about allergic rhinitis and also asthma, so both of the diseases, they are having difficulty, the patient is having difficulty peak at 4 a.m. and these are the reasons why it gets aggravated at 4 a.m. Number one, there is raised parasympathetic tone, decreased amount of adrenaline, and decreased cortisol. Decreased cortisol, increased sensitivity to irritant, and therefore there is exacerbation of rhinitis and asthma. And therefore, we prefer the drug like in night, single nighttime dose of theophylline is given for nocturnal asthma. If we require more, then we can give long-term oral administration of corticosteroid. And apart from that, nocturnal vagal hyperreactivity can be controlled by giving ipratropium and tiotropium bromide, because they are also effective in the evening as well. And apart from that, the leukotriene receptor antagonist xylitol is more effective during night time. So this is how we can make the patient comfortable by giving the drug in the evening. Now let us talk about arthritis. Now arthritis, in rheumatoid arthritis, the symptoms are more severe during 8 a.m. to 11 a.m. And therefore, we can give number one, long-acting NSAID at the bedtime. Number two, we can, if still we need more, we can give morning, here it is written, morning once a dose, a heavy dose of corticosteroid, so that it will take a whole day. Now talking about blood pressure, and also because we are running with time, दिखा रही हूँ time की, तो blood pressure and along with that we will see the disease like myocardial infarction, acute cardiac arrest, and ischemia. They are aggravated early in the morning, and the reasons are again given here: raised cortisol, catecholamine, increased platelet aggregation, vascular tone, and heart rate. So these are the conditions which aggravates the blood pressure as well as our these infarction and ischemia in the morning. And therefore we prefer the drug verapamil, which can be given in a bolus dose. And apart from that, we can give ACE inhibitors, nifedipine and amlodipine in the night, so that it can give a coverage till morning. These are again certain cardiovascular drugs which are affected by the timing. Now talking about again a very important topic, hypercholesterolemia. Now here we can see cholesterol synthesis is maximum at the night time, and the evening dose of therefore statin is more effective, which can be given to control hypercholesterolemia. Same wise peptic ulcer, we have already seen in around 7 p.m. the acidity is more. So why not to give a dose of ranitidine at bedtime, so that patient will be comfortable. And this is again a chart which is showing how and when and which drug to be given according to the circadian rhythm. Now talking about cancer, now this again the cancer therapy, in chronopharmacology, optimal timing according to the circadian rhythm of anti-cancer drugs and adverse effect of normal cell is taken to be granted. And DNA, there are two things. The DNA synthesis in normal human bone marrow has a peak around noon, while the peak of DNA synthesis in lymphoma cell is near midnight. And therefore, S phase, we attack on the S phase and the drug is given in the evening. Same wise, there are number of diseases which are influenced, like diabetes. Again, the circadian rhythm, the timing, the influence, and oral contraceptive naturally we give according to the menstrual cycle. And coming directly, because I am having an illness time, let us just have a look on the recent newer part of the chronopharmacology. The recent is the chronomodulated drug delivery system. Now, in the drug delivery system, I will highlight the pulsatile drug delivery system. Now, this pulsatile drug delivery system is a system where the drug is released suddenly after a well-defined lag time or time gap according to the circadian rhythm of the disease. And this pulsatile drug delivery system, actually, it is a part, it is a type of intelligent drug delivery system. Nowadays, we are having one more newer drug delivery system, which we call intelligent drug delivery system. And this pulsatile drug delivery system is a type of intelligent drug delivery system. And again, PPDS is again divided into various types, like time control, internal stimuli control, externally regulated, etc. And according to these types, the next slide is, we are having number of newer drugs which are available. Like, for example, we'll see first pulsin. So amoxicillin, which is again, we get that drug time control system according to the time control. Next drug is according to osmotically controlled. Other is by multi-particular pH dependent system control. So there are number of drugs now in our pharmaceutical industry which are prepared according to the circadian rhythm, or which are prepared according to chronopharmacotherapeutics. So this system is again divided into various. Just we will have a look on the types. This is time controlled system. Another is system based on osmosis, based on erosion system. It depends on the rupture coating membrane. Then second type is internal stimuli induced system, which is induced by temperature, by thermoresponsible hydrogen system, by thermoresponsible polymeric micelle system, and chemical stimuli induced system like pH sensitive drug delivery system, and glucose responsible insulin release device is there. Inflammation induced pulsatile release system is also there. Drug release from intelligent gel responsible for antibody concentration. Enzymatically activated liposomes are available. And apart from that, externally regulated pulsatile system, they are regulated by magnetism, that is magnetically induced system, electrified induced system, ultrasound induced release system, light induced release system, and there are number of other recent, apart from that, there are number of recent advances also. And hereby I conclude, and with the same statement, that it is the time where we have to switch from our traditional medicine towards the recent approach, that is pharmacotherapeutics for various. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am, for the enlightening lecture. Now I would like to invite Professor R.K. Dixit, Professor at the Department of Pharmacology and Prebiotics, KGMU, Lucknow. Sir is a fellow of, also a fellow of FAMR, UPGA, fellow of Diabetes India, and has around 59 research publications to his credit, apart from a number of presentations at national and international level. So we'll be talking about the pharmacokinetics address, a key to rational pharmacotherapeutics. So we welcome you, sir.
जब आप इंस्ट्रक्शन अच्छे से दे देते हैं देन द कंप्लायंस इज कन्वर्टेड इनटू द कॉन्कॉर्डेंस एंड देन द एडहेरेंस द चांसेस ऑफ द एडहेरेंस आर मोर सो देयर आर थ्री टर्म्स वन इज कंप्लायंस कंप्लायंस कोई भी कर लेगा लड़के से आप खड़े हो जाओ खड़ा हो गया बट दैट इज नॉट कंप्लायंस आप खड़े होने के रीजन बताइए एंड देन ही विल डिस्कस व्हाई शुड आई और आप कितनी देर खड़े रहें कब तक खड़े रहें then that is known as concordance tab wo usko follow karega and that is known as adherence so there are three terms and the last it is persistence so there are four terms actually the first is compliance which is the primary label which is actually not recommended much because compliance to koi bhi kar sakta hai aapne keh diya khade ho but that is not good compliance with the reason and understanding that is concordance when this occurs then the adherence occurs and this adherence leads to the persistence these are the four things which actually resides over the rational therapeutics so why we are talking about adherence because most often the prescriber or the prescription writer prescribes but it is not taken it is taken but in the wrong way it is taken but in the wrong way and madam has told chronobiology like suppose the prescriber physician has like written one tablet in the morning so morning may be from 6 a.m. 4 a.m. to the 10 a.m. hum log good morning bolte rehte hain 11 baje bhi good morning theek hai 4 baje uthe tab bhi good morning actually her intention was to take at the morning morning means 6 hours 6 o'clock तो अगर 6 o'clock मेंशन नहीं है सो हाउ यू कैन एक्सपेक्ट दैट स्टूडेंट पेशेंट विल टेक एट द 6 o'clock जब हम लोग बोल रहे हैं गुड मॉर्निंग सो ही विल आल्सो लर्न एंड 11 बजे ले लेगा पौने 12 बजे ले लेगा बोलेगा गुड मॉर्निंग इज वेल और आपने टैबलेट लिया 3 बार मॉर्निंग नून एंड इवनिंग तो एक उसने लिया 12:15 बजे एक लिया 1 बजे और तीसरी लिया 6 बजे तो 2 गोली एक साथ हो गई क्यों क्योंकि वो नून आ गया सो अल्टीमेटली यू हैव टू मेंशन द तो एक्चुअली दिस इज मोस्ट ऑफ अस हैव फार्माकोलॉजिस्ट बट दिस लेक्चर इज एक्चुअली मेंट फॉर द क्लिनिशियंस मोस्ट ऑफन दे राइट वंडरफुल बट मोस्ट ऑफन दे लैक द बेसिक कम्युनिकेशन एंड एडहेरेंस रिलाइज ओवर द कम्युनिकेशन एज वेल एज द understanding of the patient so not only understand with the patient so that adherence is actually presently it is being highlighted at many places and that's why I have chosen this topic and for the adherence there are simple rules means the pen number 1 rule of R is reinforcement so physicians should reinforce every time second is reevaluate within time and the third eye perfect so one is reinforcement another is reevaluation and third is reward so sugar koi akal nahi aa gaya बहुत अच्छा प्रिंसिपल बनाया है सिंपल उसका एक्रोनिम दिया है सिंपल जस्ट यू राइट सिंपल दैट इज सिंप्लीफाई द रेजिमेन दिन भर में इतना ना लिख दो कि सुबह से लेकर शाम तक खाली वो घड़ी लेके इतने बजे ये खाना अगर 10 बार उसको खाना है तो 99% वो 2 बार तो भूल ही जाएगा कितना भी ज्ञानी होगा, कितना भी मेमोरी वाला होगा, तो अल्टीमेटली अगर 10 में 2 बार भूल गया तो एडहेरेंस कितने परसेंट बचा? 80% ओनली. सो द नंबर ऑफ डोजिंग शुड बी अकॉर्डिंग टू द लाइफ स्टाइल. द सेकेंड इज यू थिंक अबाउट क्रोनोफार्माकोलॉजी, यू थिंक अबाउट समथिंग अदर्स, बट यू थिंक अबाउट द लाइफ स्टाइल ऑल्सो. तो अगर लाइफ स्टाइल से मैच नहीं कर रही है देन इट विल नॉट बी एडहेरेंट. सो एस इज सिंपल विद इन I is कुछ आएगा सिंपल लिख लो कहीं पर, मैं बता दूंगा. लाओ बेटा मैं बता दूंगी इसी यही से बता. S is simplify the regimen. I is मैं भी टेंशन में आ गया हूँ, ठीक है. और फिर इस तरह करके है तो कहीं लिख लीजिए, सिंपल आप डालेंगे उसमें आ जाएगा नेट पे, उसको आप पढ़ लीजिए. मैं तीसरा है कि एडहेरेंस का, बिना एडहेरेंस का, बिना दवा के खाए कोई पेशेंट ठीक नहीं होना. तो खाली अगर आपने लिख दिया है, खाली आपने कह दिया है, तो दैट डजंट मीन यू आर अ गुड प्रिस्क्राइबर. सो फर्स्ट यू इवैल्यूएट द process of whether the person has taken the medicine as you have prescribed or not. खुल नहीं रही है, मुझको ट्रेन पकड़नी है. थैंक यू वेरी मच. और बाकी कुछ हो तो डिस्कस कर लीजिए. नहीं नहीं मैं हूँ अभी, दो तीन मिनट है सर. ठीक ओके थैंक यू.
Thank you sir for the lightning talk and sorry for the confusion. Now I would like to try.
बोलने से बेटा नहीं होता, इससे सीखो थोड़ा सा. अभी बहुत उम्र है,
कोई बात नहीं, बच्चे सीखते ही हैं, सब सीखने के लिए ऐसा हो जाएगा. तो बात है जी,
सो विदाउट वेस्टिंग फर्दर टाइम आई वुड लाइक टू इनवाइट डॉक्टर सेम कमाल सर. इज इट एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर एंड हेड एंड फाउंडर ऑफ डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फार्माकोलॉजी गवर्नमेंट मेडिकल कॉलेज सहारनपुर. He has worked at faculty of pharmacology in Charlotte University, Greater Noida and Mahatma Gandhi Hospital, Dehradun. He has dual specialization in Department of Pediatrics and Pharmacology from AMU Aligarh Muslim University, Aligarh, and is active in both the fields. He has also authored the book on drug therapy in pediatrics. So I would like to invite sir. We welcome you and the nice speakers.
गुड
आफ्टरनून.
नहीं नहीं मिली तो आप कर
फार्माकोलॉजी स्पेसिफिकली फॉर द फ्यूचर डॉक्टर्स एंड वी आर सजेस्टिंग सम ऑफ द मेजर्स और मॉड्यूल्स दैट फार्माकोलॉजी प्रैक्टिकल कैन बी correlated and combined with the real hospital setting. So in this presentation we would be discussing current scenario, what is happening. There are certain areas which all of us agree that there is a continuous need for the improvement, that there is a need of bad side correlation of the teaching of the pharmacology. I have had prior to preparing the presentation discussions from the several of the head of the departments across the country who have given very useful suggestions. There are some renowned persons and HODs are present over here also, and it is already being done in some of the medical colleges. And we would also be suggesting some kind of the reforms that can be done. So this is the discussion and results of the second MBBS professionals. Second MBBS professionals who have suggested that our subject pharmacology is the most important subject among the paraclinical subjects. And I am happy to share that I am the part of the pharmacology. And when the MBBS curriculums have been revised days 1997, and in this current scenario, when there is a medical science in changing almost on the weekly basis, and we are presently living in the internet era, we are yet to revise what we have built 20 years back. Probably we have already revised some of the things, but there are a lot of the things that are still to be revised. And these people are also suggesting that the change should be there. So the purpose of the practical training in pharmacology is, as per the guidelines and objectives of the basic medical education, is same is applicable in the teaching and training of the pharmacology also. Mean to say, we are preparing the physician of the first contact, physician of the first contact, to impart them the clinical skills related to the drug administration. And recently, Medical Council of India have made certain changes. We are already aware of that, that mannequins have been officially been suggested to be procured for various pharmacology departments across the country. And there's a to develop a kind of the therapeutic skills that pharmacology knowledge, teaching and training can be applied directly for the management of the patients. And there is a need-based training that can be utilized in a real hospital setup, in a real hospital clinical setting. See, what is actually happening, I am fortunate enough that I am a part of the clinical side also. I am a practicing pediatrician also and pharmacologist. So, in fact, I am a kind of the bridge between the two. So, I am on the daily basis, I am observing what is the need that should be there in the curriculum. And I have already discussed several of my friends, of course my colleagues working in the pharmacology, there is a kind of the desire that the pharmacology involvement should be much more as compared to what is happening in current scenario. So the correlation of the teaching and training in pharmacology, if we are doing a kind of the SWOT analysis, that is discussing of the strength, weakness, opportunities and threats of this kind of the correlation, there are the certain challenges. And these challenges, this slide is based on the discussion of the various leaders, various head of the departments across the country, that some of them suggested that, like in KM Hospital, Dr. Nirmala Rege suggested that our wards is very crowded one. So we can't take our students to the clinical wards. Some of the head of the department have suggested that with the shortage of the faculty, we are already aware that unfortunately Medical Council of India has also reduced the number of the teachers. Now there were two assistant professors required, now it has been reduced to one. Again, it is a problem. Most important problem is that sir, in the morning, Dr. Rehan and Dr. K.P. Sharma is also suggesting that there is a need of developing a kind of the friendliness with the clinicians. That is very much essential. And there is a lack of cooperation by our clinical colleagues. In fact, if we can establish a kind of the friendship, we can expect a kind of the cooperation. Then there is a disturbance in the ward atmosphere, that is quite obvious by the presence of the number of teachers, number of students. When I was the part of this medical college were 100, now it's 150, and many more are around 250, 200 teachers are being taught in some of the medical colleges. Again, it is a problem. And moreover, with the current scenario, with the recent scenario, the many of our faculties, many of our postgraduates, they are not having the training how to apply these kinds of the methods directly to the students. And sometimes, unfortunately, there is some kind of lack of desire, but because some people think that it can be an extra burden or can be extra work. But I am happy to see that many good people, many good talents are now entering in the field of the pharmacology. And this is a happy sign. So if we can discussing it on the base of the strength, weakness, opportunities and the threats, then there are a lot of strengths. We are well aware of opportunities that students can be better trained to become a first contact physician, and of course there are certain kind of the weakness that can be addressed during the course of the time, that because lack of the training is there. And I don't see any kind of the threats. There is a positive science all around. So anyhow, pharmacology itself is changing its scope broadly, and more we are coming in contact with the clinical peoples, and we are becoming a kind of the companion in the management of the patients. Gone were the days when the pharmacology teaching was limited only on the preparation of the pharmacy exercises, liniment lotions and all, and dissection of the frog. In my time, there were a lot of these kind of the exercise, but most of these exercises have been already removed, and there are a lot of many good suggestions that have been suggested by Medical Council of India. Sorry. So we will be discussing that we have developed some newer modules for teaching pharmacology and therapeutics at our institution, Government Medical College, Saharanpur. The most radical change that we have done is that we are well aware of that it is a 18-month long curriculum, 18 months duration, around 72 weeks. I don't think that many of the medical colleges are doing more than 50. It is not possible, probably. At most, you can claim up to 60 practicals. 50 or 60 practicals. And there has to be a revision. You have to give some time during the course of the assessment and examination. You have to keep that thing in also. In our pharmacology department, when I'm talking about correlating pharmacology with the teaching in the hospital, I'm not saying that each and every practical exercise you need to take all of your students to the clinical ward. There is a difference. What we are doing, said 40 practicals we are doing in the pharmacology department, and very meticulously around 10 practical exercises we have selected that needs to be done in case of the selecting by OPD in clinical wards in the emergency department. And this is not that very difficult, and it will not disturb your clinical colleagues in a much broader way, you can say. So newer methods, we have also made some changes, that initially there was the division of the clinical pharmacy lab, CAL lab, clinical pharmacology lab experiment, clinical pharmacology, and we have made them into phase 1, phase 2, phase 3 and phase 4. See, ask our stakeholders, what we actually want. Specifically, if any student for the first day, he is being posted in the experimental lab, general pharmacology is being covered, he is not having any idea of the experimental pharmacology. So if at that phase, you will start teaching him the experimental pharmacology, he is not prepared much more. So what are the various changes that we have done in our short manual and workbook? This is not having any copyright. I can redistribute in this in the RPT conference freely, no problem. And we can hand it over. You can print your name of your medical college on the short manual. And we have selected the list of the practicals. See, the list of the practicals we have selected very carefully. Say for example, when I am talking about phase one. So in phase one, if I am talking about the first practical, we are teaching the communication skills. Communication skills with the patients. And recently, according to the Medical Council of India changes, this is probably are aware of these changes that have been recently proposed. And based on these changes, we have developed radical changes in our pharmacology curriculum and pharmacology modules. We have made a short project report, and this project report has been submitted to Government of Uttar Pradesh. It is costing of establishment of the various lab is around coming around 1,99,579 approximate. We are giving the communication skills in the first of the lectures, because communication skills are highly important, and all are agree that they are very, very important in success of the pharmacotherapy. And medicine people were thinking that this is already being covered in pharmacology.
You have already crossed the time.
So we are positive dressing that is helping in the communications. We are teaching negative postures. Then rise of the drug administration we are teaching based on the clinical studies. Then we are teaching in great details the drug labels and understanding the drug labels. Then package inserts. We are teaching over the counter medications prescription and over the counter medication differences, components of the labeling, dosage form, manufacturers. This is covered initially in the initial part, in the initial first one. And after setting, then all of the students we are sending, we have prepared a performer for the short assessment. And the students are being sent to the wards. And OPDs, they are filling this case sheet that have been prepared. I can freely share with all of my colleagues. And we are sending these case sheets needs to be completed in the OPD itself. And sometime in the OPD and IPD. And then students needs to write about the drug description in the ward itself. In the ward itself. And then we have giving them the clinical skills. Medical Council of India has suggested of procuring the mannequins, recent recommendations, the internal assessment examinations. We are this is a video, probably it is not working.
क्विक टाइम नहीं होगा
सो दिस वाज शोइंग द वीडियोस ऑफ द इंट्रावास्कुलर इंजेक्शन वी आर हैविंग अराउंड 25 वीडियोस दैट कैन बी फ्रीली डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड वी कैन शेयर एंड वी आर शोइंग स्टूडेंट्स हाउ टू गिव इंट्रावास्कुलर इंजेक्शन देन वी आर गिविंग देम द डमीज फॉर द इंट्रावास्कुलर इंजेक्शन वी आर टेकिंग इंटरनल असेसमेंट ऑन द एग्जामिनेशंस. And for the rational pharmacotherapy, there is some difference. I am showing over here also, we are having, according to practical, different sets of the drug. These drugs are meant for the practicals for the cuff therapy. Means students, we are giving the students and ask them to choose the right cuff syrup. So it is much more practical as giving to the syrup itself in the hand of the students. Then he will be much more receptive. And in the intravenous fluids, we are giving the intravenous fluid in the hand. Okay, this is the 5D. So tell me the various indications. At least you need to tell me what is the composition. And at least specific contraindication where he will not give this D5 at all. So students, after taking the this specific set, see, so we are having these different sets, and in the gynecology, I am taking them the gynecology wards, showing them the various drugs that are prescription audit. We are taking them the prescription department. We are showing them the real prescription, and specifically this we need to mention that we are teaching and training students, because each and every of us is having a laptop and tablet and a smartphone. So my clinical colleagues are taking the help of the smartphones. So we are showing them how they should use the smartphone for the searching of various drug information on the smartphones, then YouTube. Then there are a lot of videos that are available already, and that can give you very good training. And medical apps are also there. See, my clinical colleagues are already using. So why not give the teaching and training in the pharmacology department itself? This I have learned Indian Academy of Pediatrics conference. There is a specific sessions for the smartphones. So quickly I am winding it up, and clinical correlations, we are giving them the training that how they are confronting with the medical representative. We are calling the medical representative in the pharmacology department also for this purpose. And we are medical representative. What are those medical representatives showing to the doctors? Means what they are actually doing. We are giving them in the hands. It is not like that students are going to the OPD, they are seeing that with the medical representatives are coming for the short lectures also. And we are showing that there are the various pharmaceutical companies, these are the pharmaceutical strategies, that how they are alluring by sponsoring speakers, by sponsoring events, meeting, provision of the gifts, etc. Provision of valuable gifts. We are sensitizing our students that after becoming a doctor, they need to tell that how they will assess this kind of the so promotional study. So I'm quite quickly winding it up. Highlight of modern curriculum in practical pharmacology, that details of package insert form, core prescribing skills of the rules of the drug administration, drug development process, rational pharmacotherapy, how to choose a drug, use a modern tools in retrieving drug information, communication skills, therapeutic adherence, evaluation of drug promotion. So the take home message is, all of the project I have prepared and prepared on the behalf of the ISRPT to the Medical Council of India also.
You cannot send that letter. You cannot. You have to take permission of the GPR.
Sir, it is in the process.
If you
We can discuss it. For the development of newer methods for such kind of the correlations, newer methods can strengthen the therapeutic skills for the management of a patient more effectively. No existence of medicine without pharmacology. Thank you.